NFL reaching an historic settlement in a concussion lawsuit with more than 4,500 retired players. The NFL would pay $765 million plus legal costs, but admits no wrongdoing. Now, former players accuse the league of hiding the dangers of head trauma. Many of the athletes claim they suffered neurological problems as a result.
Yes, they're not accepting any responsibility for some of the things that were involved in the lawsuit, but at least they put the proper foot forward to say, hey, these players, the legacy of the guys who played the game before the current players actually matter.
Now, $10 million from that settlement will go toward medical research. And concussions during sports are, of course, not limited to just football. It can also happen during activities like soccer and volleyball. And a recent study pointing to the rising number of teenage girls being treated for concussions is changing the way that we really think about the injury. Six News anchor Lori Tucker has more right now in tonight's Caring for Our Kids. Lori?
Kristen, a concussion obviously is a brain injury that occurs when your brain is jarred around in your skull. And the bottom line here, if your child gets a concussion, experts urge you, please take it seriously. Joining us now with more is Dr. Katie Stordahl, ER physician at Children's Hospital. Always good to see you.
Thank you.
Okay, before we look at this pretty amazing video that really spells it out, how does a concussion differ from other head injuries?
A concussion is more severe than other head injuries. A minor head injury might be something like you get a bump on your head with a little cut, but you don't have any other symptoms. A concussion means that there has actually been an injury to the brain itself, where the electricity in the brain has changed in some way.
Let's take a look at that video now. You're seeing it there, and talk us through what happens. You mentioned it's jarred around and there is that disruption.
So what you're seeing in this video is that you have skull, you have fluid inside of that skull that's around your brain, and then you have your brain itself. So normally your brain is sitting in that fluid floating and it's not touching your skull. But if you get a hard hit to your head, that can force your brain to go back and hit the skull, and then it can come forward again and hit the front, actually causing two injuries.
And you know, kids are always known to be resilient. We always hear that they can bounce back. This can be a lifelong kind of situation, though.
Not typically lifelong,
no?
But it can be something that lasts for 7 to 10 days. That's how long it would be for most kids. For other children, up to 15% of children, it might be 3 months or more that they have symptoms.
Wow. And maybe long term, we don't know?
Long term, there's a lot of research, especially coming out of the NFL because of this player's lawsuit and other things that have happened with professional athletes, where we're looking to see what are the long-term effects and what can we expect in extrapolating that back to kids.
So parents, you're watching at home, let's tell them the signs and the symptoms to look for.
Well, a lot of people think a concussion means that you pass out, and you don't have to pass out. Some kids will say, I got really ringed or my bell was rung, just meaning that they kind of have that immediate impact where they feel lightheaded, dizzy, they may have a loss of consciousness where they pass out. They may have a headache that starts a little bit later, nausea or vomiting. They may see flashy lights or blurred vision. Certainly, if your child passes out and you can't wake them up, if one of their pupils looks different than the other, or if you see bleeding from their ears or their nose, those would be reasons to call 911.
All right, wonderful. Dr. Katie Stordahl, as always, wonderful advice.
Thank you
so very much. And if you have a question about your child's health, just send me an email, ltucker@wate.com. And be sure to join us every Thursday here on 6 News at 5:30 to see if we use your question on the air. Kristen?
All right.